Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. It is Friday the 11th of August and do you know what that means? It means that Olivia Rodrigo's new single, Bad Idea, Right? is out today. I am so excited to hear this song, so I thought I'll do a little reaction. I did recently do a little music reaction to Taylor Swift's Speak Now, Taylor's version, Bolt Tracks, which I loved. So if you haven't seen that already, go check that out. I do normally post book videos, but I do like a good music moment, so I'm back again with some Olivia this time. And I'm not really sure what the vibe is going to be for this song. And I was expecting Guts, which is the new album, which I believe is coming out in September. Is it September or October? Oh, now I can't remember. But I thought that the vibe was going to be like Brutal from Sour, and then we heard Vampire, and it was something a little different. So now I have no clue what to expect from this new song, but I'm excited about it. And I love the cover for the single as well. Absolutely amazing. But this song is 3 minutes and 4 seconds, so let's get into it. Here we go. A door? What was that? A squeaky door and a hay? Was that a hay? Hay? Definitely getting the Brutal vibes, my gosh. It's got like that distorted kind of quality to it. I'm not a music person, I don't know how to try and say what I'm saying right now, but it's like, you know what I mean? Like she's behind a mask. I don't know, but like I like how that sounds. Like it's not super crisp. I wonder if that will change later on in the song. It's giving like early 2000s teen movie, and I love that. I love it. She definitely does have those vibes, which I love. But since it's not super crisp sounding, I don't really know what she's saying. So maybe I need to look up the lyrics.
It's a bad idea, right?
Oh.
Seeing you tonight.
It's a bad idea, right? Yeah.
Seeing you tonight. It's a bad idea, right? Fuck it, it's fine. Yes,
that was hilarious. Yes, I know that he's my ex, but can't you people reconnect? I only see him as a friend, the biggest lie I ever said. I tripped and fell into his bed. I hope this is not about that guy, can't remember his name now because he's irrelevant. The one who Vampire was about. The one who dated Madison Beer, and I don't know his name. Do I want to know his name? No. But I kind of do. What's his name? Is it like Zach or something? Anywho, better not be him. I like that. I'd like a good stop moment. No, I should stop. But I can't.
Was asleep or never sleep where in his sheets. I love your face on the second floor when you're sore. I'm sure I've seen much hotter men, but I really can't remember when.
I love it. It's like she's talking to a friend. Like the way it's phrased and everything, I really enjoy that. And I'm sure I've seen much hotter men, but I really can't remember when. That was my American accent, that was kind of bad. Sorry. What was that? What was that? Know what instrument that is. Is that a guitar? What? That was great. That was great. That was great. I loved it. That's definitely going into my playlist of should be in a 90s 2000 movie, because I do have that playlist and I do love the songs on that playlist, and they're all songs that are like out now but should be in a 90s 2000 movie. I really enjoyed that, and that is the sound I was expecting. I love it. Very much Brutal, very much the vibe I was wanting, and I loved it. Now I'm wondering what the rest of the album is going to be like, because I feel like Vampire and this song now, they have quite different vibes, but both vibes I like. And I don't think there is a song of hers that I haven't enjoyed. So I'm probably going to love the album, no doubt there. But I just don't know what to expect. But in other music news, since it is the 11th today, we did get exciting news yesterday, Taylor Swift-wise, 1989 Taylor's version. And let me just say, I was expecting this to happen because I was actually compiling my notes and I was going to make a YouTube video about how 1989 is going to be the next album and here's proof. And I was going to show all my receipts and all proof from music videos, and I had the plan and I was too late. She beat me to it. But like, I'm so excited. Literally cannot wait. Fun fact, 1989 was actually the very first CD that I got from an artist. Like, I used to get those So Fresh mixtapes, and I would get one like nearly every year for Christmas, but then for 1989 year, 2014, little old me was like, give me Taylor Swift. And of course we got the Polaroids. Yeah we do. I loved this, still love this. Cannot wait to hear the vault tracks, my gosh. I believe there are only going to be 5, which is disappointing. I would enjoy more, obviously, but I'll take what I can get. Love a good vault track moment. Perhaps on October 27th, I will be reacting to 1989 vault tracks, which is so strange that we got 2 Taylor's versions in 1 year. Like, Speak Now was not that long ago, but then we're already getting 1989. Not mad about it, but like, what's she planning? But that is basically all I have to talk about today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. But don't forget to subscribe if you would like to subscribe. I post new videos every single Saturday, so you do not want to miss it. But I will see you next week with a new video. Goodbye.